Today I wanted to come and share with you some principles of leadership. Leadership is very, very, very important. So the principles that I share with you all today, I want you to take those principles and I want you to think about those principles because it's going to allow you to be intentional in how you conduct your leadership. So as we begin to talk about the principles of leadership, here's the first thing that I want to be able to define for you. Leadership is about influence. That's what leadership is. So we have a couple of different principles when it comes down to that leadership that we want to talk about, because if we can influence and motivate and inspire people actions, that's where our leadership really begins to take hold. So as we move into leadership, let's talk about the principles. We're going to talk about the four phases. We're going to talk about the four stages of leadership. So as we go into be a leader, it is a position that was appointed either by a CEO or by someone that actually has authority to be able to appoint someone to leadership. When you are leading, or when we are leading, we can lead by example, which means we might be in the front and we might be the first person to actually lead, or by example, which is leading. Then there is leadership. Now watch the difference out of these three when it comes down to a leader, leading, and leadership. This is going to help us form a foundation for what we think and what we believe relative to leadership. So now, leadership, the importance is the ship. There are certain people in our life that we care about, that we want to see the best for, that we want to motivate, that we want to inspire, that we're willing to give ourselves in service to make certain that we could see a 10 on top of their head. I'll talk to you about that in a minute, right? So leadership is about the traits and the characteristics that we employ on a day-to-day basis and putting a 10 on people's head just to be certain that those people have all the tools that they need to be successful. Leadership is the continual process of each one of us exhibiting characteristics that help people to move forward. There is a process to growth in anything, in any career, any job. We grow from little kids to mature adults. We grow in our responsibility. Our finances grow. There is something called the process. And one of the things that I strongly, strongly, strongly believe in is called the law of process. So let's talk about this for a second. And I want to bring this to you so that you could understand this from a very practical perspective. A lot of times when we're cooking at home, our food tastes better often when we marinate it or when we prepare it in advance and give it a chance to go through the process of the seasoning soaking and setting in. It's no different than our leadership. Our leadership says that we have to study. It says that we have to go through experiences. It says that we have to read. We have to write. We have to talk to other people. We have to submit ourselves to learning and understanding and practicing those concepts, because not only is it a process, it is intentional. So, let's begin with the four phases of leadership. As always, the number one phase of leadership is personal leadership. Personal leadership is so important because I can't give what I don't have. If I don't understand my internal characteristics of commitment, focus, development, responsibility, vision, coachability, servanthood, resilience, diligence, then it's going to be hard for me, if I don't have it in my personal leadership, to be able to share those. The second phase of leadership is called one-on-one leadership. After you have built your personal leadership, it now gives you an opportunity to almost test it and try it out in a one-on-one environment. So that gives you an opportunity to see where you are, how well you employ those characteristics that you have, and if you employ those characteristics that you have, how can you influence behavior one-on-one with somebody? Number three is team and family. It's almost like the process of growing up, coming from a baby to a young adult to someone that has a family. So now the third one is team and family. And if you're able to now take those same characteristics, employ those characteristics and have an effect on a group of people's behavior, that gives you an opportunity, again, to test where you are, to test your influence skills, to test the trust that you've built in others that allow you to inspire and motivate their actions and their behaviors. And now you move to community organization. This where another place where the charisma comes about, being able to influence a large group of people. And anyone that you have added value to, or any group of people that you have added value to, those people will always, always, always be willing to listen and understand as you communicate and share your vision and your message. So remember, I told you I would come back to this earlier. We want to put a 10 on everyone's head. That means that every time I see someone, I want to envision a 10. This is what leaders do. They envision people as 10s because we tend to treat 10s a certain way. So we want to be certain that we're doing all that we can to add value to hopefully every sharing just these basic principles. Gives us something just to be able to think about. Gives us something to be able to wrap our mind around to do some additional research. Because I truly believe that learning is about you understanding what we share together, allowing it to spark a flame in your mind, and that flame allows you to create and imagine and go and do your own research so that you can go deeper into the process of leadership. Thank you.